Today, children, I have planned to do with you people the business letter. And already we people have done the letter kinds of business letter, which we also call as formal letters. And related to this topic, we people have already done business letter regarding inquiry. Then we did the business letter regarding reply to the inquiry also, and now the second part of this business letter would be like giving a placing order. Okay, after we inquire about the things which we want to know about, then comes the time for us to either place order or to book, go for booking of the kinds of things which we were inquiring earlier. So children, tell me, first of all, let's see which topic it's about, the placing order. Students, it's very important to understand first, like, when do we place order? We place order when we have already inquired about the service, objects, or things. Okay? We sometimes ask when we go to market to buy something, it's not that we go and pick up and come back. What we do first we see, first we, you know, inquire about the objects. Suppose you want to go to, you want to buy a dress. You want to, first of all, you make sure like which place you want to go. Okay? First you inquire about the place or the shop or the kind of, you know, organization where you want to go. When you reach there, you tell your requirement. Maybe about the kind of dress you want, or maybe the kind of range within which you want the dress. Okay, maybe the kind of material, brand you want the dress. Right? So after telling your requirement, that organization shows you the product. Then you choose out of various objects, out of variety you choose, you start selecting. While selecting, you ask questions like, okay. So while making the choices, you ask those organizations to. So when you go to that place, you ask for the requirement. They start showing you the variety, and during that time you ask various questions pertaining to your need. Okay, so those questions which you ask during that shopping, those questions when you write a letter, we call them inquiry. Okay, you inquire about the objects, you inquire whether the things would be as per your requirement or not, right? So when you write a letter to buy something, you inquire about your requirements. Okay, you want to know whether the payment would be made, how much payment that organization would be expecting in advance, or how much payment what would be the mode of payment, or you want to know the kind of discount you'll be getting, or you want to know the time that organization would take. Right? So whatever the questions you want to know, those questions are answered by that organization through their letter. Right?
and you are mute.
Ma'am, your voice is not coming.
Yes, sir. So we were talking about the business letter in which we are going to place order. So after having inquired about the object in details, finally we buy the thing or finally we place order. Okay, when we go for an offline shopping, then we buy and come back. But when it is an online shopping, then we place order. Okay, while placing order, what things are to be kept in mind? Today we will be dealing with that. So while placing order, first of all, the format is as usual. Okay, I won't be going in much details with the format again, but still, because many of you always forget the format. So as far as the format of the business letters or formal letters is concerned, you should always remember that it is divided into three parts. First of all, we write the address of the sender's address comes. So if you're writing if you are writing letter to somebody, then first of all, your address will come. Okay, sender's address. On the top, sender's address. You can note down. Right? After the sender's address, we write the date. After date, we write address of addressee. That is the person whom we are sending the letter. Okay, receivers or address of addressee. So this address of addressee is very important because first of all, remember, like we must address the person to whom we are writing letter. So if we are writing a letter to the manager, then we must write say the manager. If it is the MD, the managing director of the company, then we can write that. If it is a CEO of the company, then we can write that. Okay, so address of the addressee. So first of all, the designation comes. After the designation, the name of the organization or the name of the company or the name of the school, whatever. Then afterwards comes the place where it is. So remember these three things when you're addressing the addressee. First of all, the designation, then the organization's name, third, the name of the place, that is city or the city where this place is. After address of addressee comes up subject. So subject happens to be the title of your letter in a way. Okay. When we write an article or a story or a report, we write a title. Okay. But when we write a letter, we write a subject. But subject is written in the letters when it is formal. For informal letters, the subjects are not written. Remember this. Okay, only for formal letters, the subjects are written. The subject is in a way title of the letter. So the way the titles of the story and all are always small, concise and precise, you know, catchy. In the same way, the title of the subject of the letter should also be precise one. It should be a short one, not a very lengthy one. Here, when we'll be placing order, so of course the title will be placing order for whatever the object. Okay. After the subject is written, addressing the person. So here salutation comes up. Salutation. What is salutation? Addressing the addressee. So if you're talking to the manager, if you're writing the letters to the manager, then the salutation can be dear manager. If you're writing a letter to the editor of a newspaper, then the salutation can be dear editor.
If you're writing a letter to the principal of an organization, you can say the dear principal, right? But when you are very sure that the principal or the editor or the manager is a sir, then you can say dear sir. But if you are not very sure about the gender of the addressee, then you may address that person as it is. Yes, beta, when your one section is over, when your sender's address is over, then you can leave line. After writing date, again, you can leave line. When your address of addressee is over, then also you can leave line. When you've written the subject, then also you can leave line. Okay, after each segment, you can leave line. Okay, after each one segment, you can leave a line. But yes, after salutation, you must not leave line because you've not finished off after salutation. When I talk to you people, when I say, okay, Deepali, what are you doing? I don't mean that after Deepali, my sentence is finished, my segment has finished. With this address of one name, I'm going to start off talking. Okay, so with salutation, we must not leave line. But yes, here, after each segment, we can leave a line. There is nothing to cram about it, like whether we should leave a line or not. The purpose of leaving a line is only to make our write-up a little clearer, to make it, better from presentation point of view. It's not about, it's not a very hard and fast rule that we must leave line here or we must not leave line here. It's not so. Got it? When you leave a line, then the purpose is that what you write, that should look better. That should look clear. Is that clear? So why I'm telling you not to leave a line after salutation? Because after salutation, your segment is not going to finish off. Rather, it's going to start with when you say, dear manager, I would like to ask you this or that. So salutation will be, in this case, when you'll be addressing the manager, then you will say, dear manager. Okay. So after salutation, no comma, no full stop, not even leaving a line. So after salutation, from the very next line, we can start our letter. So it is there with there where the main part of the letter starts off. So the main part of the letter, it is content of the letter. So it is here where we are to focus right now, because format you people have been doing since ages. But now see what is to be written in the inner letter where you are going to place order. So first of all, give reference. When you're going to place order, it's not that you're going to have a communication or the communication with this company for the first time. Already you had a communication with the company when you were inquiring about the things. You already inquired, that company sent you a reply, then you made up your mind to place order. Got it? So first of all, give reference to the letter number. Letter you wrote previously regarding inquiry. Okay. This letter is with reference to letter number. It might have been, there might have been some number to the letter which you wrote earlier, or there might have been some subject to the letter. So this letter is with reference to my previously written letter regarding inquiry of a refrigerator I wanted to purchase from your store. It was written on this date, or you can mention it. This letter refers to my previously written letter dated 20th June 2021. In which I wanted to inquire about the refrigerator I wanted to buy from your company. Got it? So first mention, like, this is not the for the first time that I'm writing letter to you. Earlier also I wrote a letter and I asked for the details and you sent me the answer. So this letter is with reference to the previously written letter in which I wanted to inquire about the details of your hotel, or in which I wanted to get the catalog of the books from your company. It was written on 20th May 2021. Got it? That is a reference. Okay. So after this, so letter, what was the subject of that letter? And what was the date of that letter? Or the what was the number of that letter? Whatever is applicable, you can mention. Now the question arises. Like, time is almost over, children. So time for you people to join your next class. But let me finish off one more point. So reference, first of all, you mentioned the reference. Then afterwards, you'll be mentioning the like reason of your writing letter. Like mention the reason of writing this letter. And now I have, because of the letter, because of the kind of reply you gave me, the terms and conditions of your company are very suitable to me and I'm ready to place order. So I have made up a mind to place order for my requirement, right? So children, we'll pick up the letter from here tomorrow. And again, I'm giving you a reminder that send me your holidays homework by afternoon. 12:30. Okay, so in case your homework is still pending, you can finish it off, but it will not be considered amongst the best holidays homeworks. Okay, so whatever we have discussed today regarding the letter, note it down in your fair homework. Okay, and afterwards no one will be questioning, ma'am, format, you sometimes you forget the format, so write it down. Okay, today it will take hardly 5 minutes to write down in your notebook what we have done here. Okay? Okay, children. Thank you very much. See you tomorrow. And kindly join the class well in time. Okay, your class starts at 8:30. So be there at 8:25. Today I saw like about 6 students were there at 8:20 also. They were there sitting ready to join the class. Very good. So be there. Punctuality is important. Okay, children, take care of yourself.